as we move away from traditional education. We really have to get into the 21st century learner. And the 21st century learner is a hands-on, I'll-do-it type of learner. Here at Central High School, we pride ourselves on being one of the very first schools in Jefferson County to offer a career and technical educational magnet. The whole goal of a magnet program is to allow students to have an exploratory education that directly prepares them for life after high school. The richness that the career and technical programs provide is that hands-on experience.
STEM is always innovating and it's always changing. And I think having a really good piece of innovation in the classroom for students to work with, some cutting-edge technology, is really helping prepare them for the future in that STEM curriculum.
Central High School originally reached out through our website, and they had inquired about SPOT. They had experience working with other robotics, but they didn't have experience with an industry-grade platform. So for them, that was really why they were interested in SPOT, is because they felt like they wanted to prepare their students to be ready to work with a robot that they might actually work with when they go into the workforce. And so we could tell there was a lot of passion, and there was a lot of alignment. Not only were the students huge Boston Dynamics fans, but so were the teachers.
We saw these videos on SPOT on YouTube. That's where it really started, and Jim really wanted SPOT.
I was such a fanboy, I couldn't stand it. I almost needed an adult diaper when I saw it. It's not CGI, it's real, and it's adorable, quite frankly.
First, you have to understand Jim and Chris.
But you can do it all
they
like,
eat, they live, place, they like breathe this program, right? And they are just advocates. They are allies. They're out in the community and they're saying, what can we do to change the trajectory of our students? When you have that, at some point, no idea is crazy.
Well, first of all, no one took me seriously. Every time a district official would come in, they say, what do you need in your class? I go, I need a Boston Dynamics SPOT robot. They were like, you can't have that in the classroom.
But we did some convincing. Jim and I created this proposal of sorts of why we could use this and how we could use this and what this could do in the community. How could it help underserved populations? How could it help kids with disabilities? And they were blown away by it.
No one thought we could do it, but that thing rolled in here one day and time just stopped at that point.
Jim and Chris were like two dads that had just given birth to a child.
I was like, this is insane. Like, I can't believe this.
They sent out pictures of Reggie coming out the box. They sent out pictures of Reggie's first steps.
The original Reggie was a little pit bull puppy that we found in the school across the street. We took in the dog and kind of nursed it back to health in our vet program. And that dog for 13 years came to Central every day. It was the best behaved thing you've ever seen in your life. We love that dog so much.
Not only does Reggie fit, you know, our school, but it, you know, it's just that constant memory of the real Reggie.
Let's go, Reggie.
And the kids began to maternally treat Reggie like, this is our brother. Reggie has a school ID. I mean, he's in the yearbook. I mean, he has truly become a part of the Central family.
So as a mechanical crew, that's going to be your first job. We need to retrofit one of our old bases with a swerve drive setup, okay? Automation has been going on since the first steam engine was built. I need my students not to be replaced by a bot. I need them to manipulate the bot, control the bot, fix the bot.
Being able to use SPOT in high school really feels like I'm far ahead of a lot of other people, and I'm really grateful for that opportunity. It gives me such a unique way to see robotics and use Python that I would never be able to get anywhere else.
Super cool.
I just think it gives me a lot more of like real world applications. Just having something that is within the world that like can be used and I can see the effect on it.
I think it's safe to say they know more than Chris and Jim.
They go way beyond anything that I teach them, and that makes you feel so good as an educator, where you see a student that you gave a little bit of knowledge and they grew that out. We have companies come in here to learn about SPOT, and I always just turn it over to the students, and they will teach like police officers how this works, how this functions. So they're walking out of here with those kind of skills. genuine spot operators. It's wonderful to put something like that on a resume.
And some of the comments and feedback that we've gotten from university instructors have been, wow, your Central kids come in and they're like, oh, I've worked with that, I've done this, I've tried that. And so it just really gives them leverage to really be successful and to make the four-year commitment when it comes to college.
Reggie's kind of an emotional support animal. You see kids that react in ways that they never react about other things.
Seeing students who have nonverbal skills, just their eyes are talking. Their bodies lighten up when they see Reggie and when he lights up. We have a student that struggles with touch. But when Reggie comes around, he has good hands, he's touching, he allows the robot to get near him. And so just seeing that impact, it's been phenomenal.
Sometimes those kids get left out. And people kind of, you know, maybe sometimes dismiss them, or sometimes they don't think about them. And the really rewarding thing about what Reggie does is that it brings everybody together.
Diva, I'm so proud of you.
I know.
The idea of Central High School started in 1870, and six African-American community leaders got together and they put together about $4,000 to begin a school. And so the first school, it was called the Louisville Colored High School, and it was the first and the only school for African-Americans here in Louisville.
A lot of our kids here live day to day. They may have some challenges at home where they're not really focused on what's going to happen in 5 or 10 years. And this program allows them to think outside the box. It allows that non-traditional classroom to really come alive, and they see themselves in those programs. And they go to places like Boston Dynamics and they see, wow, this could really be me. This could be my future.
Being able to see Boston Dynamics, we were able to see in real time a lot of the things that we didn't realize could be possible. I was able to see a lot of people that looked like me or like had the same passions and interests as me. It was inspirational because they were all wonderful in working with teams and communicating. So I think that was a very important skill that I had to learn. And I realize that now, and now I see it.
I would be on YouTube looking at these videos, looking at Atlas like dancing to all this music. But in person, Atlas, you could feel the vibration of the floor. You could hear the sound of it like landing. It's really cool.
It's life-changing for them. And every kid that we have taken has gone to engineering school. They say that's the moment that I have to be an engineer. That's the moment where they can see themselves there.
When we see students that are graduating from Central having those scholarships to University of Louisville, and we know they're going to be going there to study maybe in engineering or programming, it's very exciting for us. It's very fulfilling, and it shows the hard work that Central High School is putting into their students.
It's really incredible being here at Central High School, seeing the development from when we started the relationship 2 years ago to now. And it's really just so impressive to see what these kids have built, to see how they've progressed their academic careers, and to think that SPOT or Boston Dynamics could be a small part of that just really warms our heart.
We were very thankful, and we still are today. It's like one of those things that it never gets old for us.
And it just really gave the kids a breath of fresh air. It really revitalized us, educators, teachers, the programs. Reggie just became like this heartbeat of Central High School.
Hopefully everybody at some point can have a SPOT robot, and they don't have to be a well-off school. They can be an inner-city school. And that's, I think, the great story, is that we're doing this on the low budget scale, and that paves the way for everybody else to do it.
If you give the students the right tools, you give them the right equipment, all students can achieve such great goals. It doesn't matter about their background. It doesn't matter about their neighborhood. You give them a chance, and they can do this.